Hello and welcome to this video. My name is Shilpa and I'm part of SAP S/4HANA Product Success, Co-Innovation and Content team. Today, I'll be sharing highlights of some of the most important and interesting two-tier ERP scenarios coming up with SAP S/4HANA Cloud 2011 release. Let's get started with the first one. SAP's Intelligent Real Estate Scenario, which supports all key future-focused topics, including space management, remote work, sustainability, cloud, and analytics. This provides centralized master data model in the cloud, enabling end-to-end real estate business processes between headquarters and subsidiaries for both commercial and corporate requirements. Customers can make intelligent leasing decisions with embedded analytics and contract and lease management solution. We also have new SAP Intelligent Real Estate Fiori apps that helps in usage and occupancy management, supporting different business scenarios such as external lease out, internal occupancy, and intercompany lease out of spaces. Second scenario is about managing the green line. SAP Product Footprint Management application helps to calculate product footprints periodically and at scale, considering the entire product lifecycle. Users can replicate business activity and master data from subsidiary that is on SAP S/4HANA Cloud and headquarters that's on SAP S/4HANA on-premise to SAP Product Footprint Management. It acts as a primary source for footprint calculation based on a specified set of plans and time range. We also have SAP S/4HANA Cloud Fiori app, View Product Footprints, using which footprint calculations can be searched. Our third scenario is in services area. Generally, headquarters use resellers or retailers as a channel of sales to increase customer base. Similarly, customers reach out to resellers or retailers in case of issues with a product. Here, resellers or retailers not only act as a channel of sales, but as a channel of service. In most of the cases, services of the product is taken care at the subsidiary that is on SAP S/4HANA Cloud. However, in certain complicated cases, genuine parts needs to be procured from the headquarters on SAP S/4HANA on-premise. Here is how it works. Subsidiary interacts with the customer and creates in-house repair. A quality check is done and a repair order with a part that needs to be procured is added, resulting in the creation of a purchase requisition, which is then converted to a purchase order with vendor as headquarters. At the headquarters, a service order is created following a delivery order and goods issued to subsidiary. The repair order is done at the subsidiary and product is delivered to the customer. Between the subsidiary and the headquarters, vendor-supplier invoicing is done for account receivable and account payable. The fourth and the final scenario for this video is also in services area. As you know, solution order enhancements have been part of the last few releases. With 2011, we have the new sales item with third-party integration. Let's look at one such scenario again, where we have subsidiary on SAP S/4HANA Cloud and headquarters on SAP S/4HANA on-premise. With change in businesses and processes, increased customer interactions, service providers not only provide installation services, but also procure products from headquarters. Let's understand how the process flow works. The subsidiary interacts with the customer and creates a solution order for sales and services, resulting in a purchase requisition, which is then converted to a purchase order. At the headquarters, sales order is created against the purchase order and performs goods issue. Goods receipt is done at the subsidiary and issued to the customer. Service order is created and replicated in FSM, that is Field Service Management, where a field agent is assigned for installation of the product. Finally, one invoice is sent to the customer post-service confirmation, and vendor-supplier invoicing is done between subsidiary and headquarters. Don't forget to check out our two-tier ERP blocks for further details. Thanks for listening.